How can you turn these sprite sheet characters into anything that you want? And make these pre-made characters into poses that did not exist in the first place and have absolutely no limit to what you can imagine and do with these sprite sheets? We'll see how to do it simply using Chat GPT and a more elaborate way in Photo Pea and Illustrator, and use them in static pose changes, very popular now, or in an animated way with unlimited possibilities. Straightforward as usual. Let's dig into it. In previous tutorials, we went over how to use sprite sheets. And although you have a lot of choice and options for your poses and movement, you might find yourself limited and wanting more poses for your character. So here are a couple of ways. In this first example, I managed to create different variants to my character: laughing, eating a sandwich, drinking a soda, and crying. And the way to do this is pretty simple. Chat GPT. All you need is give it these two instructions: don't crop the body, and transparent background. Just put in your complete instructions. This way you don't need to do it every time you ask for a new pose. And then just ask for your poses or expression. It works pretty well. Download them in PNG, and you're done. I did the exact same thing for all the other poses, and it got it right every single time. Now, Chat GPT will not be able to make all your dreams come true. And some things will have to be done manually. Let's start easy. We got this sprite sheet with many assets and positions. We open it up in Photo Pea, for example, or Illustrator. First, let's remove this background. We won't be needing it. And let's just try to make this little guy walk, and we'll do a little modification. First thing as always, locate groups and folders. To do that, select any part of the object you want and go to the parent folder on the right panel. Rename it, in this example, walk number 1. And do the same for the other ones. This way, we'll navigate through them more easily. Okay, now let's say we don't want the briefcase, or want to replace it with something else. We go check in which group it is. You do this by testing with the eye icon. And as you can see, the briefcase is composed of these two groups. We deactivate them, and do the same with the other positions. Then create a smart object for each and export to PNG. We went over this in the last tutorial, so let me just skip this part. And we have our walking animation, as wanted, without the briefcase. Let's now look at another example and try something different. This time I'm in Illustrator. And we got this sheet here with well-organized body parts. Each group is a distinct body part that can be manipulated. We also have various face expressions. And first thing to do is to scale up to get a good resolution in our PNG images. And we can right away start composing our character. So I'll start with the base, head, torso, legs, and go get some arms. We'll try to make this guy cross his arms, and we can use this rotation feature. Duplicate another frame and just rotate the arm a bit. We can do something like 8 frames, each rotating a bit. And for the last frame, we'll just get these arms, already crossed from the sprite sheet. When you export all the frames and put them in a video editor, you get this. Let's try something else, and make the face expression change while he's crossing his arms. So I pick out these 3 heads that look like a progressive smile, and place them in sequence by replacing the old ones. Place the first one, and make sure it's on the right layer. Generally should be on top layer. And do the same for the rest of the frames, each time changing the head with a slightly different expression. And if you really want to, you can also play around with the eyebrows. After exporting, you get the same animation, but with a changing face expression. Let's now try another thing. Make this guy stand up from his chair. and we'll create 5 frames with him progressively standing up. We use the rotation of the legs and the height of the body. Each time the legs rotating in and the torso going up. Just make sure that his feet stay stick to the ground though, and for the arms, same thing. Try to play around with the available arms and adjust the rotation angle to make it more lifelike. When the guy is about to stand, go for some legs that are ready, and just copy-paste them. And when you're done, you might get a surprising result. Obviously, these are just a couple of frames, but you get the idea. The more frames you make, the smoother it will be. Moving on, let's say we want our character to hold a TV remote or a banana. We go to our sprite sheet and pick what looks like the best arm for that. I choose these two. And the only thing to do for the remote is to remove the old object, resize and place. You might also need to put the layer up or down. In this case, the remote is in the background. For the banana, same resizing and placing story. But the twist here is to select some fingers that will have to be on top of the banana. Select the fingers and put them on the top layer. Regroup and place. And there is your character holding a remote and a banana. Let's look at another twist we can do. We'll try to make our character laugh. Once again, you pick heads that look good for the job, and you create a sequence of frames, each time changing the face expression, as the character laughs. But the twist here is to play with the height of the head between each frame. One higher, the next lower. This way it gives this cheesy laughing effect. Obviously, these techniques might take you a while to get used to. But for my examples, it took me just a couple of minutes, maybe 10 or 15 minutes, to make a set of 8 frames. Anyway, hope you guys liked the video. If you did, make sure to leave us a comment down below. Until next time, cheers.